Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to do a little update number one on the Wilson Combat Ultralight Carry Compact. Now, I know it's kind of soon to do a little update on this gun, but I was on a hiatus for the past month, right? And I've been doing a lot of shooting with this gun in the past 4 weeks, so I kind of do want to give you an update on what's going on with this gun. I also got a lot of emails and messages from random and fellow YouTubers out there asking me, hey, how's that 4-inch barrel 1911 doing? Is it choking up? You know, has it failed on you? You know, what are you doing with it? So we're going to talk about that right now. So basically, guys, I am going to retire the hack. Oh, no. This gun here is going to get retired. And why is that? Well, basically, the Wilson Combat Ultralight Carry Compact has been 100%. I've put even more hardball through it. I am definitely over the 1,000 round mark. Maybe 800 rounds of hardball, and I don't know how many jacket of hollow points. You know, so this gun works. It has not failed, and I'm very, very impressed with this handgun right here. I really am, because back in the day, I would never ever consider a 1911 with a barrel shorter than 4 1/4. The commander size 1911, even a commander size 1911, I was like, nah, you need a full government 5-inch. And that's what I liked, you know. And that might be because my bias came from certain shooting classes that I had to attend or I was attending. And I would see these guys show up with these micro-sized 1911s made by Kimber. And they were jam-o-matics. They were less than a 4-inch barrel. Those things just do not work. Or the classes that I were at, those guns never work. Even a 4-inch barrel 1911 I've seen choke up a ton, like Kimbers especially. Even some Springfield Armories. So, yeah, back then I was like, no way would I ever get a 1911 with a barrel length of 4 inches or even less than that. Even today, I wouldn't even go less than 4 inches. But, hey, Wilson Combat, they know how to make a reliable 4-inch barrel, compact, lightweight 1911. And that is A+, very cool, because I'm not sure how other brands would work out, you know. I was thinking about Dan Wesson for a little bit, but I guess I just like Wilson, I'm dedicated. The Hackathon Special has been 100% from day one. So far, so good with this. Granted, it hasn't been that long, but it's proved itself to me, basically. So I'm going to transition to carry this gun right here, the Wilson Combat Ultralight Carry Compact. I think it's going to work out very, very well. I already started to carry it the other day, and wow, it's night and day. So I definitely am going to pursue this as my 100% CCW carry gun, and we'll see how that goes. This is not going anywhere. No way. I might go back to carrying this. You never know. But this gun does mean a lot to me. It's got to be one of the most reliable 1911s that I've ever owned, bar none. I'm being totally honest with you guys. Never choked up. The thing just works. It's a warhorse. It's a fighting handgun, I believe. The finish is wearing off up here. It's weird. I feel like the finish on this slide is a lot tougher than this one. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's just in my head, but we'll see how the finish holds up on the Ultralight Carry Compact. But, you know, I could send this back right now since I'm going to retire this for the time being. Maybe I'll send it back to Wilson, have it refinished in gray-black. Gray frame, black slide. I've always wanted one of those. So, but then again, I don't need to, you know. So I think I'll just kind of leave it alone for now. But I am going to retire the hack, but it's going to be available to me if I need it. So it's pretty cool. This is kind of like a mini version of the Hackathon because it kind of looks almost the same. Just some minor differences. And of course, the major difference is it's lightweight, much more, you know, it's a much more compact 1911. Compact 1911. But it still has the same concealment hammer and beaver tail safety, medium, you know, pads right there, triggers. Serrations on the rear of the slide, top of the slide. So it's very similar, but this doesn't have a bushing because it's a 4-inch barrel. Much shorter grip, rounded butt. So I'm really excited to carry this. And like I said, I did carry it the other day in a TT Gun Leather Mike's Special. The Mike's Special is made for a commander size 1911, But this thing fits just fine, and I mean, you know, 4 1/4 and 4 inch, not that big of a deal. But the major difference right away was that the holster for something like this, which is the TT Gun Leather Slim XC, it goes pretty deep into the pants, meaning because it's a 5 inch barrel. This one right here, 4 inch barrel. Definitely could tell the difference when I was carrying this one. And the second major difference is, of course, the weight. Big, big difference. So I'm very, very pleased with this. Like I said, it's reliable, and I like how it carries. I definitely like how it carries. The carry load that I am going to use with this gun is going to be the Korbon DPX 160 grain. All right, it's a 160 grain, so kind of an oddball weight for a 45 ACP. However, everything that I've read, even Bill Wilson himself, has recommended the 160 grain for the 4-inch barrel, Wilson at least. So I'm going to go with that, and the DPX is a very good jacketed hollow point. But we'll see how this works out. I mean, I put like over 100 rounds of the DPX through this without a hitch. So to me, that's pretty good to go. Ranger T's, I put even more than 100 rounds through it, and that was good to go as well. So those two rounds, a standard pressure 230 grain Ranger T and a 160 grain DPX standard pressure, both work pretty good. I'm going to use the DPX though, the 160 grain, the lighter bullet. I did want to try out the Wilson version, which is a plus P 160 grain DPX, but unfortunately they don't want to ship ammunition to my state because of the hassle. So, oh well, I'll just settle on the DPX 160 grain standard pressure. They're almost identical. I'm not really sure what the difference is besides one being plus P offering the exact same specifications as this one. So kind of weird. And they call this a, you know, this is for more of a short barreled or compact gun. So if you guys have any information on the 160 grain DPX, leave it in the comment section below. A lot of people are like, well, why don't you get a 9mm 1911? I don't know. Call me a traditionalist. I do like the 45 ACP in the 1911. I like the 45 ACP. This one right here. I mean, look at that. I just love that gaping hole. It's crazy. That just looks intimidating, right? But, yeah, I just like the 45 ACP. It's personal preference, I guess. I can control this gun very, very well. No problem. Recoil is definitely not a problem for me. And I just like the 45, that's all. Maybe I'll look into a 9mm 1911, but I don't know. I think I just like them in 45. But who knows? That may change. That may change, as with anything. When I think 9mm, I think of the Beretta and the SIG for some reason. But nothing wrong with the round, you know, but I just prefer 45. So that is the update. This gun is working out very, very well. I'm very excited. I know it does have a fiber optic front, and some people do not like that, but I like it. Nighttime, sure, you can't really see it, but I'll have a flashlight. I may, you know, in the future, change that out and put a night sight up there, a tritium front night sight, but I don't know. I kind of do like the fiber optic green. This one has a gold bead. It used to have the green fiber optic, but I took that out. But I don't know. Who knows? We'll see what happens. You know, we'll see what happens. But for now, I'm going to move over to carrying this, and I'm pretty excited about it. I think it's a really nice short-barreled, I guess if you want to call it that, lightweight 1911, 4-inch barrel 1911 that actually works. That's awesome. So all I can say about Wilson Combat, A+, and you definitely do get what you pay for. So alright guys, that's about it. So you can leave some comments below, let me know what you think, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later!